Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. Go and open the file 00_031_DIABM where you saved it. You can download this file on the website or use your own file to follow along. If you don't have access to any XSS file, you can just sit down and watch the video. Now go to the quick access tool and click the save as icon. This brings the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_035_DIABM and change the file of type if you plan to open this file in earlier version of AutoCAD. Click this down arrow. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007. Click the save button. Now zoom out to see the entire drawing. Select this drawing, use the Windows layer and select this drawing, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this drawing and hit delete on your keyboard. Now select this drawing, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. As specified base point prompt, use the center object snap to snap to the center of this circle. As specified second point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap to the center of this circle. Now use a window selection to select this object and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the view control and select the view manager. Select the first floor plan and delete all the custom view in this drawing. Click OK to close the dialog box. Now go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent. So in the previous tutorial, we have learned the different method that we use to create a solid in AutoCAD. In this tutorial, we're going to use the extrude command to fast track the process of creating a 3D object. Go to the top right corner of the screen and click the vertex in the view cube. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the make current button. Click on this object. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the isolate command. Click on this layer and press enter. Now type join on your keyboard. Select this object, press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. At the select object prompt, press enter, trim off this object. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and this line, this line and this line, this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Hover the mouse cursor and try to find out which objects are not joined well. Type join on your keyboard, press enter, select this object and press enter. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select line command. Start the line from this point and move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Select this line and this line. Type join on your keyboard. Press enter. Select this object and press enter. AutoCAD join this object. Now go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object prompt, use a window selection to select this object. Press enter. Move the mouse cursor up and type 3000 millimeter and press enter. Now zooming into this area is it's like we have another hidden short line under this polyline. That's why we see the surface. Select the surface and hit delete if you have the same situation. Now go to the visual control and click the down arrow. Select realistic. Now select this polyline, right click, isolate, hide object. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. Select this polyline. Press enter, move the mouse cursor up and type 3000 on your keyboard. Press enter. Now go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the box command. At the specified first corner prompt, click on this corner and move and snap to this corner. Move the mouse cursor up and type 1000 millimeter. Press enter. Type the box command again. Click from this vertex, press enter. Click on this vertex, start from this vertex, snap to this vertex and press enter. Click on this vertex, start from this corner and press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. Click on this vertex, move the mouse cursor and click on this vertex for the opposite. Press enter to accept the default height. Now we need to check this window if we have the actual measurement. Because we copy this plan in the ground floor plan, there was a toilet window in this area. Now type DI on your keyboard and press enter. At the specified start point prompt, click on this end vertex, move the mouse cursor and click. We need to increase this opening into 900. To do that, go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the press tool command. At the select object or select bounded area prompt, click on this face and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 75, press enter, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button, click on this face. Move the mouse cursor into this area and type 75, press enter. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the box command. And specify first corner point prompt, click on this vertex and move the mouse cursor and click on this opposite. Move up and type 1000 millimeter and press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. And specify first point prompt, first corner prompt, select on this corner, type L on your keyboard and press enter. Move the mouse cursor and click on this vertex. As specifying width prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap inside. Press enter. Hold the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Press enter to repeat the command. Start the box command from this point. Type L on your keyboard and press enter. Move and select this vertex and click to select this width. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the command. Start the box from this vertex. Type L on your keyboard and press enter. Select this vertex and press enter. Hold down the shift key and zoom around. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the box command. As this is my first corner, start the box from this corner. Type length L from type L on your keyboard and press enter. Click on this vertex. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this vertex. Press enter to end the command. Go to the 3D tool tab, modeling panel and select the box command. Click on this vertex and move the mouse cursor and click on this vertex. Move up and type 1500 millimeter. Press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the box command. At specifying first corner point prompt, click on this vertex. At specifying other corner point prompt, move the mouse cursor and click on this vertex. At specifying height prompt, move the mouse cursor down and type 800 millimeter. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to repeat box command. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to start the box command. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to start the box command. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to start the box command. Click on this vertex and this vertex, press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. Start from this vertex and this vertex, press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to repeat this command. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to repeat the command from this vertex, press enter. Press enter, start from this vertex, press enter. Press enter, click on this vertex, type L on your keyboard and press enter. Select this vertex and this vertex, press enter. Press enter, click on this vertex, type L on your keyboard and press enter. Click on this vertex, press enter. Press enter to start the box command. Click on this vertex, type L on your keyboard and press enter. Now hover the mouse cursor into this vertex and this vertex. Slowly move into this area and snap to the perpendicular object snap. Now snap to this point and press enter. Click on this. Press enter to repeat the box command. Click on this vertex. Now hover the mouse cursor into this vertex and hover the mouse cursor into this area. Now move and use the intersection object snap. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. Click on this vertex. Type L on your keyboard. Press enter. Click on this vertex and this vertex. Press enter. Press enter. Start from this corner and the opposite corner. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command. Start from this vertex. Type L on your keyboard and press enter. Select this vertex and this vertex. Press enter. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. Go to the 3D tool tab, modeling panel, and select the box command. At specify first corner point prompt, click on this vertex. Type L on your keyboard and press enter. Select this vertex and move the mouse cursor. Snap to this vertex. Press enter. Press enter. At specified height, move the mouse cursor down and type 800 millimeter. Press enter. Now go to the 3D tool tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Use a window selection to select the entire object. Press enter. Go to the home tab, layer panel, isolate object. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, click down arrow and select the cabbage layer. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and start the polyline command. At specified start point front, clip and this area, move the mouse cursor, click, use the endpoint object snap and click into this area. Type A on your keyboard and press enter. Turn off the auto move button on the status bar. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this corner. Type L on your keyboard and press enter. Move the mouse cursor and snap into this area. Snap into this area. And snap into this area. Type A on your keyboard and press enter. Move the mouse cursor and snap into this area. Type L on your keyboard and press enter. Type C and press enter to close the figure. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the freeze command. Freeze the stairs layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this object and this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor down and type 150 millimeter. Press. Go to the view control tab, click the down arrow and select 2D wireframe. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. At the select object point, select the external solid, press enter, then select the internal solid, press enter to complete the operation. Go to the view control, visual style control, and select realistic. Now select the slab, go to the home tab, layer panel, and move it to the first floor slab layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab layer panel and click the floor layer button. Go to the home tab layer panel and click the and isolate command to bring all your layer. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent button. Right click into the drawing layer, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. In this tutorial, we extrude our first floor. We create a 3D solid for our first floor walls. In the next tutorial, we'll copy this file to the ground floor plan. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.